Our most recent release, version 20.1, includes an entirely new WPF Splash Screen UI component. As I'll describe shortly, this new splash screen control offers a number of advantages over its predecessor. It is much faster at startup, offers more appearance options, and allows you to deliver splash screens that change based on the DevExpress theme applied to the underlying app. Our WPF splash screen also supports Microsoft's Acrylic effect. Before I start the tutorial, a quick word or two about splash screens. According to Wikipedia, I quote, "Splash screens are typically used by large applications to notify the user that a program is in the process of loading. Splash screens provide feedback that a lengthy process is underway. Occasionally, a progress bar within the splash screen indicates loading progress. The splash screen disappears when the application's main window appears." I don't want to overestimate or underestimate the value of a splash screen in desktop apps. Each project is different, and you are the ultimate judge as to the importance of a splash screen. What I can say is that we've done everything possible to make our splash screen fast to load and easy to customize. With that, let's get started with this tutorial. I'm going to use our standard WPF demo app to demonstrate the splash screen's capabilities. To follow along, simply launch our WPF Utility Controls app and navigate to Splash Screen Demo via the navigation bar. I'll focus first on our Fluent splash screen. To display the actual splash screen in this demo, I need to click the Show Splash Screen link. As you can see, our Fluent splash screen includes built-in animation options and uses Windows 10 acrylic effects, the term Microsoft uses to describe semi-translucent windows. Let me display the splash screen again and move it around to show you what this means. Note that as I move the Fluent splash screen, its background changes as it moves across the desktop. Very cool. Okay, onto a different type of splash screen. If you don't like acrylic effects, or if you want to fully synchronize the splash screen with your app-wide theme, you'll probably want to use our themed splash screen. Let me move to the Style dropdown and select Themed to demonstrate. As you can see, this splash screen mirrors the underlying theme applied to a DevExpress-powered WPF app. In this instance, the splash screen uses our Office 2019 theme and a blue appearance option. I'll go ahead and change appearance color to green and display the splash screen once more. In the first instance, the splash screen replicated Microsoft Word's color scheme, and in the second, the splash screen replicated Microsoft Excel's color scheme. If you prefer PowerPoint's color scheme, you can set appearance to orange. Regardless of theme, be it an Office-inspired theme as seen here, or a custom theme, our themed splash screen will always mirror the color's style of the app itself. So far, I've shown you how to load Fluent and themed splash screens. Now let me turn to a third option, an option for those who don't want to display a full-blown splash screen during startup. I'll change style to weight indicator to demonstrate. Notice that this third built-in option displays a simple and small weight indicator window. You can either use this indicator as a splash screen or use it within your WPF app to communicate app state for time-consuming operations. Either way, be it a splash screen or an in-app weight indicator, theme color selections are always respected. Now let me focus on a few important usability features. First, let's look at the purpose of track owner position. Once you set this option, the splash screen tracks the movements of its owner. In this instance, it tracks the main form window. Note that the track owner position option is not restricted to the actual form. The splash screen can be set to track any element within the form. This will be of value to those who wish to use our weight indicator within a running app. For instance, you can associate the weight indicator with a grid control and display the indicator above the grid during time-consuming data operations. Once track owner position is associated with a specific control, the weight indicator will always track the position of the control on screen. Yet another option of note is input block mode. You can use this option to lock access to form input when your weight indicator or splash screen is displayed on screen. You can also disable locking or limit locking to specific areas when necessary. For instance, if I set input block mode to none and display the weight indicator once more, you'll note that I can still interact with the app even though the weight indicator is displayed. Okay, The last splash screen control feature I'd like to mention is the ability to move the splash screen itself. I'll switch to a themed splash screen to demonstrate. The value of this particular feature is obvious. End users can now move the splash screen to a specific location on screen so as not to block other running apps. I'll stop here, but I do want to mention that you're not limited to these three built-in splash screen styles. In my next splash screen control tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to create custom WPF splash screens with the DevExpress splash screen control. I hope you've enjoyed this brief overview of our new WPF splash screen control. If you'd like to evaluate the capabilities of our entire WPF product line, feel free to visit devexpress.com/try to download our free trial. As always, if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, comment below. And remember to subscribe and ring the bell to have access to more great DevExpress videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.